Well, perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect. Almost pleasant traveling with company, if you ignore all the less pleasant aspects. I'm ready. Take two.
Let's get going.
I wasn't expecting it, but I'm glad to have some company on this journey. What's next?
No one's stopped me yet. Let's have a look. Moving in. I'll give it a shot.
Maybe there's another entrance. There is work to do.
I've a lot on my mind and, well, in it. These boots have seen everything. What's inside? Something good here, I hope. With a flick of the wrist.
Some help. What's next, I wonder?
Can't give up now. Should mind my step.
thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Best be careful.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it?
Just a dumb boar. You're relieved. Until you see the flash of a dagger.
You can try. But first you'll tell me what you know. I saw you on the ship. You're in league with them, aren't you? Those tentacle... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on? I'm not an idiot. It has to be those tentacled monsters. Something they did. They took you too. I saw it during whatever just happened. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. I'm out of wine and flowers, so I hope an introduction will suffice. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. The strong and silent type. All right. Please tell me you at least know something about these worms. Turn us into... Ha! Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Wait, that's it. You're doomed, sorry, and then off to the next adventure. These worms are doing something. I can feel it. What are you going to do about it? Funny. Well... Maybe I'll see you again. Still wearing the same skin, I hope.
should speak up.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. Yes, you feel hate, and you deserve to be punished for it. You should be whipped, made to bow before this creature in shame. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Your mind's fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance. A vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Death is too good for it. Anything of use?
Dead goblins over there. Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
Broken. Must have been here a while. Another broken trap. Who made these things? And yet another. Hardly the warmest of welcomes. looks unstable somehow.
You approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Norse Lloyd as well.
I don't know what transpired exactly, but the ship broke into pieces and I suddenly found myself in freefall. As I was plummeting to certain death, I spied a glimmer quite near where I estimated my body to impact with less than savory propulsion. Recognizing this glimmer to be magical in nature, I reached out to it with a weaving of words and found myself on the other side, as it were. How about you? How did you survive the fall? Vast burning wreckage behind you somewhat contradicts your story, but here you stand, so who am I to argue? Still, swashbuckling heroics aside, I have the unfortunate suspicion your survival is still very much in jeopardy. Back on the ship, you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region, were you not? The insertee we speak of, this parasite? Are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. And it looks like we're both starved for answers. We're most certainly going to need a healer, and soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent. A parasite shared is a parasite halved, or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Yes?
At least things have stayed interesting. With haste.
Tiring business, isn't it? All this traveling and adventuring. Why don't we take a little break, Allow ourselves a few moments of rest. Gives me a chance to talk to you about something. Well, rather important. We've been on the road together for a while now, haven't we? Survived some perils, overcame some obstacles. Ever since you were kind enough to free me from that stone, I've seen you demonstrate remarkable guile and courage. In short, I've grown to trust you. The reason I make a point of saying this is that I've grown confident enough to tell you something I've yet to tell another living soul, except for my cat. You see, I have this condition. Very different from the parasite we share, but just as deadly. The specifics are rather personal, but suffice it to say that it is a malady I've learned to live with, though not without some effort. What it comes down to is this. Every so often, I need to get my hands on a powerful magical item and absorb the weave inside. I can say no more on the matter. Not now, anyway. Just trust me when I say it's all of vital importance. It's been days since I last consumed an artifact, since before we were abducted. It's only a matter of time before my craving returns. That is why I turn to you. I need you to help me find magic items to consume. It is vital. Dare I say it? Critical. We've already done the finding. In fact, you have one in your possession. You know for yourself how hard won such an item was, and it will be no easier when even more are required to assuage my hunger. There'll be danger involved, or great cost. Splendid. Bit of boldness will serve us well. I'm sure we won't have to look very far to find what I need. Faerun overflows with magic-infused treasure. As do our packs, as a matter of fact. We've such an item already in our possession, primed for the moment the need arises. I hope I can count on you.
goes nothing.
No hope of clearing this without a shovel. Ah, it's packed too tight. I'll need a shovel.
There could be all sorts of loot in that thing. Don't you want to be rich?
Of course I want to be rich, but not if it'll get me killed.
Both twice as tall as me, but have half the bloody backbone.
But we don't know what that thing even is. And what about the crypt?
I'm telling you, it's a ship. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already. That's our ship. Oh, yeah? Well, we're...
I ain't fighting him. Not a chance.
We're leaving. Come on, move it!
You're more cunning than you look. I thought we had a fight on our hands.
Wouldn't take much to send that stone crashing downwards.
Have you give a book? Everything all right out there? Yeah? I'm always worth a bit soft. But I've got plenty of friends who ain't soft. Come in here and you can meet them.
Can't afford to stay idle.
Still breathing, despite everything. One day I'll catch a break. What's hiding here? Wouldn't take much to send that stone crashing downwards. Better not be cursed. There's something underneath here. Wouldn't take much to send that stone crashing downwards. Strike you down. Yeah. even after everything.
Will guide me.
Time to rest. How much farther can I go? No handle. How does it open?